Hey guys, what is up? AwesomeTheSauce here. Hope you guys are having a great day, and welcome to a video that is a very, very interesting topic that I wanted to talk about. The name of the game right now is Fire, and honestly, Fire has been in a really, really weird spot for the past month or so. So this is not a video just, you know, ranting about this change. It's more of just asking the question of, is it too much? But Sauce, what change are you even talking about? I'm talking about the damn new Gearset combos from the new pack. Now, if you guys don't know, basically the new pack gives Fire the ability to be able to essentially get extremely, extremely powerful stats. More powerful stats than it's ever had access to before. And one of the best ways to unlock the full potential of these stats is by going glass cannon. So right here, I haven't made the pet yet, but I'm showing you guys what might actually become a very normal setup for a lot of fire wizards. So the gear that I'm rocking is the dragoon hat with the turquoise robe, with the dragoon boots. I'm rocking this wand that gives 7 pierce. This will become very important later on. I'm rocking the dragoon amulet and the dragoon athame. We got the daredevil ring, and we have this pet at the moment, but imagine any triple double furnace pet, except on the new Fossil Avenger pet. Now, we also, for reference sake, we have the Fossil Avengers mount on. As you can see, if you have 2 pieces, our second piece would be the pet, you could actually unlock 8 extra damage. So if I were to make this Fire Beetle onto a Frillosaur, whatever the Fossil Avenger pet is called, I would basically have the stats I currently have, except I would have 8 extra damage. We would be looking at 8,500 health. We'd be looking at, I'm not joking about this, we would be looking at 171 damage, 44 resist, 31 accuracy, and 40 pierce. There would be 40 goddamn pierce with 170 damage. You're not really giving up other stats anyways. You still have really good shadow pip rating. You'd still have really good pip chance. If you really wanted, you could, instead of having 171 damage, you could rock like 165 damage and have dragon lance, and you would have 100% pip chance. These stats would be, like, for lack of a better way to describe it, extremely, extremely amazing, OP, incredible. It would be the most powerful damage setup the Spiral has ever seen. Now, here's the thing. I honestly think that Fire needed a buff. And the reason I say that is because for an overtime school, the overtimes are some butt cheeks. Let's look at what I'm talking about. And I think there's a huge problem with the way Fire is at the moment. When I'm talking about overtimes that are not good for Fire, the only exception to that rule, is Fire Elf. Fire Elf is actually a very, very powerful 2-pip hit. It does almost as much, it actually does more than the low end of a Lightning Bats, and it has a utility of an overtime. Fire Elf is extremely good, but let's look at all the other overtimes. Power Link. Yes, it does do a minor small hit, and then it does a major overtime hit, but a lot of that damage is taken away because it's a heal as well. The damage just, it's not high enough for you to use a Link ever instead of a Fire Elf. Unless you're trying to bank on that heal, which is very small, especially with the crit nerf, Fire Elf is almost always going to be better than Link and Power Link. Burning Rampage. Yes, it does hit, but it doesn't do a 3-round overtime hit. It can be very easily triaged. The remaining overtimes that are lower than 9 pips, Scald, Nautilus, and potentially Heckhound, all of them don't do a small hit and then do the overtime. All of them just do the overtime. Now, why am I making a big deal out of the initial hit? It's because an overtime is actually only powerful because of the initial hit. The reason most people use overtimes, and you'll really notice this with poison, with death wizards, and frostbite, with ice wizards, the reason people use overtimes is because they want to break shields and leave their opponent open for a follow-up hit. By leaving the opponent open for a follow-up hit, it draws the question in the opponent of whether a triage or a shift is a good idea. If someone has 2 shields and you cast a heck count on them, it's never going to be the wrong move to triage. But let's say this Heckhound were to do an initial hit and then start doing 3 rounds of damage, right? Then because it could actually break two shields in one turn, you would actually think about whether it's actually a good idea to triage or not, because you're open if you do triage or shieldless. You will be completely open to a big hit like an FFA. The lack of overtimes for fire that do a small hit and then do a big hit over time make it so that it is very, very undervalued for being an overtime school. What I'm trying to say is overtimes are just not that good because of triage TCs and shift TCs, and even if they were good, fire does not have good overtimes. So for that reason and that reason alone, if you look at what the Ifrit nerf did to fire, it made them go back on their school identity, and their school identity is just not that strong. So a fire buff is not really a bad thing. However, I think that this is where, what I'm about to talk about, is where the problem gets a little iffy. Unfortunately, when King's Isle nerfed the Ifrit card, they kept the Ifrit TCs just the same. Now, I don't personally use them, but a lot of people have access to these. I have two of these myself, but a lot of people use these as a way to cheese the system. Now, I'll be honest, I think 170 damage and 40 resist, it doesn't actually have to be inherently overpowered. But while these Ifrit TCs are still in the game, it's always gonna be overpowered. Like, I'm really happy that fire got a buff. And honestly, if this was a way they were gonna buff them, I mean, I would have preferred if it was through some other means and not a peck that you have to pay crowns for. But even if they did get some sort of buff, at the end of the day, it's always gonna be too much of a buff with these minus 90 TCs. When you have 171 damage and 40 pierce, a minus 90 Ifrit is always gonna win you the game. You will never really find yourself in a situation where a minus 90 Ifrit TC can't get you out. Because at the end of the day, not only is a physical Ifrit doing a lot of damage, as long as your opponent doesn't have a shield, which you can easily take off with Fire Elves, they're basically gonna be open to an FFA. And all I'm gonna say is a fully enchanted FFA with just one buff, whether that be a crit, a bubble, or a furnace make cast, one of these with these stats will take away anybody's health completely after an Ifrit. It's almost easier than ever to do a two-shot combo, and unfortunately, Ifrit with a minus 45 is already good. A minus 90 is just an overkill. So while I like that Fire is actually getting a buff, because it was clearly one of the worst schools at Visionary 1v1, I think that this specific buff had to be accompanied by a ban on Ifrit TCs that do minus 90. And honestly, as someone who even has the pet that gives a minus 90 card, I genuinely wouldn't mind if they also made these no PvP or reverted these to minus 45 as well. I guess it does make sense why a minus 90 pet card would be a lot more powerful than a TC. I think a lot of people think that. At the end of the day, if you have this, you have to keep it in your hand. You can't just discard and draw for more. And by keeping it in your hand, now you're working with only 6 cards that you can manipulate instead of your full 7. There are drawbacks to this item card. But even then, with stats like this, I just don't think a card that hits and does a minus 90 is a good idea. The reason I'm making this video is because I am fully, fully convinced that there's gonna be a pretty big repetition of history with this Fossil Avenger gear set upgrade. I think that the last time that everyone thought fire was not gonna be good was when turn-based was introduced, because everyone thought that their normal overtimes and all their normal strategies that they used to do wouldn't really work the same, because at the end of the day, you could always triage their overtime. But at the end of the day, Ifrit still made it good. Just as everyone was adapting and every fire wizard was coming up with their own strategy, me included, I got 1200 rank adapting to the change. Just when things were looking a little different, now they've been thrust into a glass cannon meta once again. And with these minus 90 TCs, just, you know, with these still around, you risk some fire wizards actually trying out the strategy for the purposes of trying to be better, and you risk people just being basically unable to be beaten just off of this TC and those stats alone. It's a very mixed bag, but I do think that if you're gonna buff fire, especially with stats, just like the Dragoon gear set that gave fire much more damage than everyone else, it seems like this pattern of giving fire all this damage but keeping them able to do a hit that does a minus 90 TC weakness, It's not a formula for success. I still think these TCs are a uniquely broken part of the game. I think out of all the TCs that still exist after the spell audit, this is the most problematic one, because Ifrit was never really that good for the damage as much as it was for the utility. Sure, these TCs can't be enchanted, but at the end of the day, 1000 damage and a minus 90 is honestly gonna do more with the gear set than it ever did without this new gear set enchanted. It's the truth. If you have one or two extra buffs, an unenchanted TC is honestly going to do a lot more anyways, especially when you tack on an 8 extra damage. I don't know. I think fire might go from the bottom to the top depending on just whether someone has these minus 90 or free TCs. And I personally just don't know how I feel about that, and that's kind of why I made this video. As always, I'd love to hear y'all's opinions about where you think fire should head, and do you really think that this gear set is a solution? Do you think the gear set without the free TC is a solution? Do you think neither of them are the solution? Let me know what y'all's opinions are about the state of the fire wizards at Visionary PvP. As always, y'all, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Leave a sub if you're new. There's tons of links in the description, including my Twitch, my Twitter, my Discord, my Instagram, and of course my Patreon. Thank you for all the love on Patreon. I love y'all. As always, if somebody hasn't told you're awesome today, they're doing something wrong. So stay awesome. And yeah, y'all.